there's a great art to miking a vehicle, and there's no one fixed way. The fun part is, how do you mic an in-motion recording? a pretty typical setup might be a microphone on the muffler. By its nature, the sound of a vehicle is coming out of its muffler. Most of its sound is coming out of its muffler. So that's a point that you want to be capturing, not only from the exterior recording of a vehicle, but when you're doing your interior recordings, or what we call onboards. And we do those in separate passes. We'll do all the exterior maneuvers, start and drive away, in and stop, you know, pass-bys, and then we'll re-rig and put microphones all around the vehicle for what we call the onboards, because we're going to be in motion all the time. Then we'd like to have an interior perspective of the vehicle. I like to have at least a quad setup, because if the perspective of the camera is you're inside the car, you want to feel like it's sort of there's a left, right, and a left, right surround, so you feel like you're inside the cockpit of the car. So I want to have some interior cockpit feel behind me. Then there's a lot of controversy about how do you mic the engine. I don't particularly like the sound of microphones in the engine compartment, though many like to record that way, because I feel you get too many of the mechanics that you don't actually hear when you're inside a car. Nobody shoots a movie from inside the hood. They shoot movies from inside the, you know, the passenger compartment. So you should, my favorite way is to place some microphones, spot mics, right up by the firewall, right behind the dashboard, and get that engine perspective, so that if you're going to rev it and do some kind of performance-based driving, you get a decent feel for the engine without the tappet clatter or the valve train and the air conditioning compressor squeal. You know, you just don't want all those miscellaneous sounds, because they're very mechanical and clattery and I think distracting in a scene about probably two people talking. Unless it's a movie about cars. I mean, you know, if it's a Fast and Furious, that's a very different aesthetic. And again, that recordist, that person capturing that sound, is going to take into consideration the kinds of sounds that you want. I know in those Fast and Furious movies, you cut to the engine compartment and you see the blower or the supercharger. In that case, you probably want to have two or three mics inside the engine compartment, because you want to hear those flaps open up, or you hear the carburetors open and breathe and suck gasoline down into the manifold. So you're kind of, you know, you're thinking creatively based on the movie when it comes to where your microphone's going to be placed. Then, you know, then there are, it depends on what you know, if it's an old farm truck and he's bouncing along in the back 40, you might put a microphone or two in the wheel wells, because you want to capture the suspension creaking. It's an old farm truck. You might want to hear the dirt and the rocks kicking up inside of the wheel wells. That's a classic sound of driving along the farm. You know, if a car or an old farm truck, and we just did this, part of your workup might be suspension squeaks. And it's fun to, like, get in the back of the car and, like, push on the back corner of the bed and go, eer, eer, eer. And those are nice sweeteners you can add as you're bobbing along inside the cab, you know, checking out the back 40. Part of what we're trying to create is verisimilitude. If we can convince the audience that you're in that vehicle, then they more quickly suspend disbelief and sign on to whatever's happening dramatically. So anytime we can make a vehicle sound like it's what it really sounds like, we've helped the filmmaker tell a little bit of the story.